Okay, can you see me?
Yeah, you're real close.
I'm up close, that's good. We're gonna rig Michael Storer designed Oz Goose for the first time, so we'll see how long it takes. I've got the ring up there at the aim towards the back, right?
Mm-hmm.
That's kind of important. I've got this cleat on this, the right side of the, and I just turn it, just yank like that, on the right side of the mast. And the sail will go on the left side of the mast. And the idea is to home. I'm not pulling something to start with. Okay. I tied a figure eight knot in the side that's going to be attached to the block, so just to hang on to it. Okay. Good, I get the other string. And then we're gonna hook this to the yard. It's right there. All right. Per his instructions, there's a a line around the yard. I'm gonna put this under, and it's wrapped around three times. I'm gonna put it under. I should have got something to pull that up a little bit, because my fingers don't do anything. Got it fairly tight. I guess I should stretch a little bit. This is mid position on the yard is where this line is. I'm going to run it down to the forward end of the yard.
You have to go around the mast first.
I'm going to have to get closer than this too. This isn't going to work. Attempting to do this without scratching the boat up. Seems how Don hasn't picked it up yet. Here, put that under there. It's going to have to come further forward. Like I said, this is the first attempt, so we don't know what we're doing yet. Simple bowling is all it requires. Okay. Grab that in so it doesn't bang on things. Figure eights, and then they say wrap it around about four times and snug it, and then throw the rest of the line back in. Okay, get the halyard back up. Okay, the one difference here is the preventer I've put on got a bowline. Down at this end, we leave this permanently on the mast, or on the boom. Bring it down here, and they're saying that there's a center line right here, which should be directly above this loop here on the deck, the pad eye. And your idea is to not let the boom travel any further forward than 10 inches from this eyelet right here back to that line. So it shouldn't be moving back and forth a whole lot, okay? So, from the center. Closed. A couple of cheap and dirty knots, half inches, will hold it there. Do that. Get it tied. There's one. Alright. We had to make a change on this because we don't leave enough room down here. It's a good thing we built the mast about 3 inches long. Let's see. Am I all the way up? Yes. Okay, so we're going to tie the downhaul to this pad eye. A reef knot. And if I were going to go out of this, I would actually tighten, put another clove hitch under there too. But I'm not going out, so I'm not going to worry about it.
Sure, Don will take good care of himself, right?
Yeah.
Him too. Right.
Push down on the front of the yard and haul in on that baby. Throw your line in. Okay, let's swing her around that away. Can you see me?
Yes, sir.
Through the traveler, right here. Up through this block on the yard.
Boom.
Boom. Whatever.
Oh, stick
and
head.
You can see I've got it twisted.
About the twisting thingy, right? Doesn't there? Yeah. nice picture of your back.
I'm not a professional. And this is supposedly a ratcheting block, which I have no idea how it works. So I'll leave that too. There's your main sheet. Okay. Alright. We have the bungees around the rudder. To lower the centerboard or dagger board, whatever you want to call it, push backwards and it'll drop down. This is enough to keep it upright. Okay, let's get a couple close-ups. Of the rudder. Get the bungees. You go around it three times. She uses a pin going from the top down to the bottom through the gudgeons there. Traveler here on the main sheet. And this is where the main sheet starts, right here. And this outhaul, that's pretty good. And the main sheet goes here mid-boom. And the pad eye here for the downhaul is 10 inches from this silver ring on the sail. The preventer, tied a bowline back behind the preventer, run it through here and just eye through that hole and make a couple of clove, or no, not clove hitches, whatever, what do I call it? No, what's the other one that nobody, everybody can tie? Never mind.
Boom.
Half hitch. How about a half hitch?
Half hitch.
Yeah, that's what it's supposed to be. Whether it is or not, it's the next thing. Once again, they don't recommend tying this off. We put a cleat down here to tie off the bungee. For the dagger board.
You can see you're going to have at least a foot of dagger board down to get to miss this boom when it goes back and forth.
Yeah.
At least a foot.
Yeah. You better take it out. We simply tied the toe straps around the front there back to a pad eye here that's bolted all the way through. That is two pieces of 6mm ply with a piece of 3/4 inch or 7/8 inch mahogany in between. So it's plenty strong, I believe.
Two pad eyes back here.
Tiller extension there. Pad eyes, Don wants those for tying up to docks and stuff if he ever ties up to a dock. And we did put a bow eye type thing to, so if he wants to tow it or once again tie it off to a dock. Let's see, what's it look like from a distance? Pull the stuff off the side. Throw it down inside. And the sail was made by, what was it, Biltosh? Is that right? Don't know. Anyhow, Duckworks. It's Chuck the Ducks guy. That's all, folks.